night's performance, it has become our annual tradition to start our year off with a recital of our classical faculty. We have all of our brass, woodwinds, strings, piano, and voice areas represented tonight, and we're very excited to perform for our lovely audience. We hope you enjoy the performances today, and if you're encouraged to do so, there's a QR code on the back. Then the funds will go to our classical scholarship. That QR code will take you to a general website, and then you can choose from the drop-down box for the classical scholarship funds. Thank you so much, and we hope you enjoy the performance.
This is a work, it was originally composed, despite what the program says, in 2020. It was originally a choral work. It was for women's voices. It's by composer Carrie Magin, who teaches at Houghton College in New York. And as a choral work, there is text to it, and I thought you might want to know what it was. So the text comes from Sarah Teasdale's Love Songs collection from 1917. The poem is called Barter. And I will find the beginning of it. So, life has loveliness to sell, all beautiful and splendid things, blue waves whitened on a cliff, soaring fire that sways and sings, and children's faces looking up, holding wonder like a cup. Life has loveliness to sell, music like a curve of gold, scent of pine trees in the rain, eyes that love you, arms that hold, and for your spirit's still delight, holy thoughts that star the night. Spend all you have for loveliness. Buy it and never count the cost. For one white singing hour of peace, count many a year of strife well lost. And for a breath of ecstasy, give all you have been or could be. So this had been a choral piece. It has now been arranged as of this summer for the present ensemble. But I wanted you guys to have that little extra bit of knowledge of the motivation for this. Anyway, hope you enjoy All Things Beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you. started in Ukraine, it's been far too long. And in the over a year and a half, there have been 500 casualties and injuries. And this affected families all over. This next piece, the Skoryk melody, has been heard all through, since the war began, all through Europe and American concert halls and so forth, in solidarity and support of the Ukrainian people.
Thank you. sincero. Il tutto ricuserò, io l'ingegno puzzerò, alla finza che verrà.
Farò giocare e cento trappole. suite in D minor by J.S. Bach. The suites are super popular for all the instruments now, originally for cello, but this was a really special piece for me. At one point of time in my life, I used it as kind of a warm-up to begin my day of practice and really kind of allowed myself to get caught up in the phrasing and the just music of it all. The prelude is really special, I think, because like back in the day, if you look at the original manuscript, there's just like whole notes and stuff like that, because it was meant to be improvised. But now, of course, most of the time, as far as I know, all the time we read, it's been written out and we read, you know, the music. But I like to try to play it like an improvisation.
Thank you.
before this one too, because this is probably a composer most of you have never heard of before. Her name is Juliane Reichardt, but before she got married, her name was Juliane Benda. So I don't know if any of you have ever played any Benda piano sonatinas before. That was a big name. The Benda family was an incredibly musical one. Across in multiple places of Europe, Juliane's father, Friedrich Benda, worked in the court of Frederick the Great. So she grew up in an incredibly musically rich household. She was a published composer during her time, which seems significant for the 18th century. This piece that you'll hear is the final movement of one of her piano sonatas, and it was published in the year before her death, because unfortunately in the 18th century, we did not yet have antibiotics and modern medicine to help when you die in childbirth with your third child. Realities of life at the time. So anyway, this is the final movement, a Rondeau movement, from Juliane Reichardt's third sonata. It's very brief, but I hope you enjoy it.
It's a very convoluted story, and it's really hard to tell the story to an audience without actually reading a tiny bit of a synopsis, so that's what I'm going to do, so you're no more confused than I am. The Rhine maidens are guarding magic gold. If anyone renounces love and then makes the gold into a ring, he will become all-powerful. The Nibelung dwarf, Alberich, does this. Then slays his brother Mime and all the other Nibelungs. Votan, who this evening will be played by Sachiko, the chief god, hears of the ring and descends to Nibelheim in pursuit of it. After being captured by Votan and forced to give up the ring, Alberich curses it. Votan is warned by Erda, the earth goddess, that's me, to avoid the ring. In this warning, she warns him twice. Sachiko, when you hear a lot of interludes, he's interjecting things. That's Votan. He's asking Erda, what else can you tell me? Right? And then she warns him again. By the end, she's done, because he then wants even more. She's telling him, just leave. Do not pursue this ring. And that's how it ends. So, Erida's warning from Das Rheingold.
Thank you. Thank you. questo rendo a me. Felice ancor io son se abbracciarti possio. Io ti salvai.
Thank you.